RWB, just idling at 143 and listening to Travis Sinclair's greatest hits. The sun was shining and the birds were about, except for a couple I had to take out when I left the road to avoid a big kangaroo. Now I like birds just as much as you, but I've been through three front ends in this ute, and that suicide skippy was determined to make it four. Tearing around cars was becoming a trend, dotted line, double lines, even on the bends, when a major event made me rethink the things I was doing. A cloud of smoke came in my rear view, my hair stood up, and somehow I knew that the brown dog was hot off a meltdown and running behind. I knew it was him as his truck whistled past, his eyes were bugged out, he was pooping broken glass, and the blow-up doll riding shotgun was trembling with fear. Rubber and sparks was flying out the back, and it looked like a bushfire blowing from the stack, and his rearview mirrors were gone and one side was smashed. I turned down the stereo and gave him a call, said, "Browndog, you copy, mate, what's going on?" The reply that I heard made me fear for the motorists ahead. But for the last 3 days I've been melting down, I run out of gear, so I asked around town, all I could get was these goddamn acid trips. But me and my leprechaun are hooking along, and I don't think we're doing too many things wrong, and I'm lucky these unicorns are so damn easy to cut. Now this scared me more as he powered through a dip, cause he stopped hauling stock when he smashed that ship, and the trailers he was pulling were flat tops full of freight. I thought somehow I've got to try to stop this machine, but it's going to be hard because the little fella's keen and he's driving like he's got a big cramp in his Achilles tendon. I said, "Mate, I know you sort of push for time, but if you pull up ahead I can feed you a line." Well, I've never seen a truck start stopping like this one did. Smoke pouring out from the tyres that were left, and the screeching and crunching made me wish I was deaf. Then the trailers all started to try overtake each other. Well, I pulled up watching in absolute horror when a voice at me window said, "How you going, brother?" Which frightened me more, cause the truck hadn't even stopped skidding. There was two grey nomads in a truck stop bay, and I thought, "This is it, mate, this is their day," as an unmanned truck and three trailers headed their way. Well, it would have been good if it had all stopped there, but it smashed up the caravan and camping chairs and spread all of Grandma's washing out the flat. At the edge of the scrub appeared a grey-haired man with an axe and a little bit of wood in his hand, which he promptly dropped when he saw his home scattered about. Well, his white face turned a mad shade of red as he lifted his axe and started going off his head while making a definite beeline for that Kenworth door. I said to the brown dog, "Dude, get in. I don't want to see how this is going to end. Let's bail and be thankful that nobody really got hurt. Yet." The very next day in the local rag was a front page picture of a plastic bag, which a cop said was full of dangerous acid trips. The story continued on page 2 and 3, and I was surprised they had someone in custody, and I wondered who the bloody hell did they pin for that. At the bottom it said continued page 4. When I turned the page I nearly hit the floor, when I saw who was locked in the back of the paddy wagon. With her mouth wide open like the day she was born, and trembling with fear cause she knew she was gone, was Browndog's old style doggy style, any hole half busted, well used Acme blow up doll.